The Future Ahead Book. Written by Deng. A Brief Introduction to Chapter 10. Chapter 10. The End. It's been a long ride. First, I appreciate you for making it this far with me. If you are reading the last chapter of the book, chances are you're either searching for more information or falling in love with my story. For whatever reason, I am grateful to have shared my story with you. My account is just like any other story in the world. But the main reason for sharing my story is that I do not believe in war to bring about peace, because it never achieves real intent. War divides people, and both parties who engage in it will lose lives, making the winning of the war pointless. By now, I hope you have learned something. As I mentioned in the beginning, the book focuses on three areas: my childhood, life experiences, and lessons I have learned on my life journey. I was born in a small town, which is now the capital of an oil-rich region, South Sudan. Even with its resources, the city is still struggling and at war because of political disagreement. My experience created a lens through which I view the world today and influence others' attitudes and beliefs. Leaving my family behind in early 1985 because of the civil war was a new chapter of my life. The journey was an emergency exit, and I have never returned to my birthplace. I lost my parents and three brothers in the war. One of my older brothers was killed after South Sudan's independence in 2011. I experienced a lot as I navigated through cities, from the East Africa to the West, the United States of America. Many questions that never depart from me are whether life still has meaning and if happiness is worth pursuing. Even the South saw the light of freedom, but things did not change much as expected. My existence and meaning of life were recreated from my association with others. Living life, for now, is what I can do. Is there a benefit to my existence? And will it be notable now or after my death? In war, there is no winner because both parties lose something valuable, be it human lives or properties. I can tell you about a person who lost five loved ones in the conflict. War should not be the first solution to resolving a disagreement or dispute. Like any war, clashes leave behind sad stories for both sides, the winner and the loser, of the competition. During the war, there was no communication except with the government. I did not know when my parents died and when my other two brothers were killed. I left the country in 2005, before the peace between the South and North Sudan. The conflict between North and South led to division, but this was not surprising because of political, religious, and cultural differences. Refusal to be weak in my soul. In my experiences, war leaves a trail behind, death and sadness, in your life forever, though some might celebrate a war victory. I am sharing my story to inspire young children or adults so they can have hope. Even if you see no way out, believe that you can make it with little help, even without parents or loved ones. It is vital that you focus in order to make it through the struggles. It will not be an easy journey or straight line, but you can get there safely. Be hopeful, even if it seems impossible. When I look back on my life, I cannot believe I've made it this far. I left my town with nothing, and I didn't even know where I was going, but each step I took led me to a new place, and that created a desire to continue. The future is ahead. In my journey, I hoped that one day, things would change for the better. The trip was full of ups and downs. You believed in God one day, and the next day, you don't. In one of the previous chapters, I told you that my childhood was promising. We had food and other things that made living joyful, until the war broke out. Also, my tribe norms and culture were Deng standards, but after the war, I went through many experiences with cultural changes, and as of now, I can call myself multicultural. My birthplace. I was born in Pareng town. It is closer to North Sudan and is the state where most of the oil of South Sudan comes from. Pareng is the wealthiest and poorest city at the same time. Even up to this moment, no one knows where the oil money goes. People are still suffering. My childhood was promising because my parents had enough to fulfill our needs. Life was simple, the Jing tribe depended mostly on cattle rearing and farming. The lands are packed with natural resources that do not require technical skill or machinery equipment. Life experiences throughout my beautiful childhood shaped me to become who I am today. My journey was better and worse simultaneously. It allowed me to see the world as it's and took the fear away forever. We will be the third world class until we change our thinking. What you get in life is what you see in the real world and not in your imagination. What everyone has is their vision that has been brought to light. Your world is given to you by the power of your imagination. You can go to the moon when you believe it. We can go to the moon without help from others, and that day, our people will have their independence. Most African countries are dependent on AIDS because of poor leadership, lack of imagination, and poor thinking. Their way of thinking creates poverty instead of wealth and knowledge. The book is now available online as ebook, paperback, and hardcover on Amazon, Googlebooks.com, Barnes and Noble.com. Get your copy today. For more information, visit us at www.onyutime.com. Also, on my YouTube channel, Making Learning Accessible. Thank you. We're Deng.